Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the delayed flight. We have the 787-9, the Boeing Dreamliner of 4Simmers. And please keep notes and be extremely attentive, otherwise you will never be able to land this plane with an ILS guidance. There is a trap here which is unique. Indeed, it is unique and I have never seen in any other of the Boeings that I fly. Please support the channel, comment, thumbs up, because this is kind of information that you cannot find. Write alt and we press here. We bring the PFD here. This is extremely important. Let us magnify a little bit. Here is our PFD. And as you see, we don't see any horizontal or vertical guidance. Actually, we don't see any ILS activated. Though we are quite close to the runway. I mean, we are a few miles far from the threshold of our runway, which indeed has an ILS frequency. So what is going on here? I don't know if the same problem also appeared with the 787-10, the default original Dreamliner of Asobo, which is included in the premium deluxe edition. But here I think things are quite obvious. You don't have any ILS frequency. So what you do about it? These things we have said lots of times. Usually, for you who are familiar with ILS procedures, you go here, okay, navigation, and you have a look at your ILS frequency here. There is nothing written, isn't it? It is just fine. It is not the first time that you don't see your ILS frequency, so you must put your ILS frequency manually. This is what we always do. How do you put your ILS frequency manually? Our runway is runway 10, and the ILS frequency of the runway, which is a log DME frequency, is 109.50. So here it goes. Please have a look. You go here, 109.50, and manually you set the ILS frequency. And normally this should be all. However, here there is a surprise. Please have a look. You see? Invalid entry. It is not accepted. This is the way that you put the ILS frequency in every Boeing when you use the FMC. You always type the frequency and you go here and you press the button here and immediately the ILS frequency is established. However, with the Dreamliner, with the 787-9, this doesn't work. So what do we do about it?
Huh?
I want to repeat once again that this is kind of information that you cannot have access to. So please be attentive. So 109.50, it is not enough to establish our ILS frequency for runway 10. Makedonia Airport, runway 10 has an ILS guidance. And so, ladies and gentlemen, here it comes. You continue. You press slash, here you go, okay? And then you type the runway. The runway is runway 10. That means 100 degrees. So you continue. First you type the ILS frequency, 109.50, slash, and then 10, which actually is 100, isn't it? So, 100. Have a look here. We don't see nothing on the PFD. We don't see any glide slope or any localizer. The moment of truth. Here it is. You see? Now it is accepted. 109.50, and our runway is runway 10. And actually, at the moment, you see here on the PFD, I hope it is visible, please have a look at the cursor. Can I magnify this one? I will. You see here, the glide slope is established, isn't it? Not the localizer, okay, we veer. It doesn't mean that ILS frequency always works, actually. But the only way to establish the ILS frequency is this one. You type the frequency, 109.50, for example, here, slash, as you saw, and then you type the runway, not RW10, but 100 degrees, 109.50/100. And here it is, and now, as you see, the glide slope appeared. So now, for instance, I can go here. Actually, I don't have the lock mode established. I have only the glide slope, and maybe it will disappear. And anyhow, I can press the approach mode. Here it is. Okay, let us perform an ILS landing according to the things we said earlier, just to show you how this works. So we go, as you see, to navigation on the FMC, and we type the frequency of the runway, which is 108. No, it is not. Which is 109.50. Ah, snap. So, according to the faucet, we go to the nav on FMC and we type our frequency, which is 109.50 slash, and then we type the runway, which is 100. So, here it goes. We see both the localizer and the glide slope on the PFD, which is maximized a little bit on your left, and I have disengaged the auto throttle, and the plane now tries to follow the vertical and lateral navigation according to the ILS frequency that we set. Here it goes. I set my gear down. We monitor our altitude. Actually, we are hands-free right now, isn't it? Which is about 2,000 feet. I don't touch nothing. I just monitor my instruments, a speed of about 200, which must be reduced, and an altitude at the moment of about 1.8 thousand feet. So, the moment of truth. We have set approach mode on. If we have both the glide slope and the localizer, we set approach mode on, and of course autopilot is on. If we have only the localizer, we set lock mode on, and we have only the horizontal guidance, isn't it? But now both work just fine. You see, the plane descends by itself. Of course, ILS landing is a miracle of modern technology. We don't touch nothing. We just monitor our instruments, and we just have a look at our speed, which is at the moment about 159. You see that we continue descending. Exactly. We are perfectly lined up, 600 feet, hands free. Soon we will disengage the autopilot, 500. Better to disengage the autopilot with this knob and not on the MCDU. Exactly, autopilot is disengaged. Now we have the control. 46, 30 feet above the ground. Excellent. Another problem of this aircraft, except the peculiarities with the ILS frequency, is that unfortunately it veers. It veers everywhere. It veers on the runway, it veers on the taxiway. You must be extremely careful. But anyhow, the truth is that we had successfully an ILS approach, and we managed to land on runway 10 at Makedonia Airport, Greece, which has an ILS frequency 109.50, runway 10. I think I recorded my landing, this one. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't think it will insist at the moment. Maybe later we can watch our landing, which was not bad at all. Just remember that you don't only type the ILS frequency, in our example 109.50, but you also then continue. You type slash and then you type the runway, full degrees. If it is runway 10, you will type 100, slash 100 if it is for instance runway, let's say 15, you will type 150. So, ladies and gentlemen, I think this is all for now. Maybe we will continue later if there is something else, and we can also have a look at our landing. Thank you for watching this clip and hope to see you soon to the next one. Till then, you take care and bye for now.